Okay, so from today we are going to talk about the last topic for this class, which is sintering, which you should already have some idea. The process, typically you have to use heat, also that's why we say heat treatment process of ceramics, but people also use the word for metals, but mostly for ceramics, sintering, a thermal heat treatment process for ceramic green body. Green body means particle packed together, but you are still have individual particles. They are not solidly strongly bonded together. To transform this green body, individual particle compact together so that they bond together, so that we eliminate the porosity between them, also called densify them. Densify them, make the powder compact denser, remove the porosity, and at the same time bond the particles together. That's called sintering. Okay, it's a very important process, mostly used for ceramic processing, and people do this, remember, below the melting temperature of ceramics. For metals, sintering is used less because for most metals, people can do so-called casting. I can heat up the metal powder or whatever metal pieces to high enough temperature, which is not difficult to reach, and then everything become together, bonded together, liquid, right? They bond together, everything together. And then when they solidify, typically doesn't have too much porosity. Unless my process is poorly controlled. Make sense? So for metal, people don't use sintering that often. Of course, there's some type, people call powder metallurgy, people sinter some metal. For example, tungsten, you sinter them. You don't really go to the tungsten melting temperature, 3000 something, to melt it and then get solidified tungsten. The reason being tungsten, to get 3000, the difficulty would be what mode I'm going to use to hold my 3000 above degree C liquid tungsten. I have no mode. Unlike for aluminum, for copper, even for steel, I can just use sand or some other ceramic as my mode. But for tungsten, what am I going to use as my mode? I don't have many good choices. You see the point? That's why sintering is primarily for high temperature materials, which is specifically ceramics. We said most, not most, but at least a significant portion of ceramics, those oxides, those carbides, borides, nitrides, quite often have very high melting temperature, which is means it's difficult for me to melt it and densify it. So that's why we have to start with so-called powder compact, or we call green body, apply heat, but not too much heat, not to the point that I melt it. And under that condition, I remove the pore, which we call densification, and bond the powder together. That's called sintering, okay? There's several major factors that impact sintering. Composition, right? What material are we sintering? I'm sintering aluminum oxide versus silicon dioxide versus carbide versus boride. And even for the same aluminum oxide, I can add different so-called sintering additives, composition. Okay, starting powder characteristics and packing. For example, are you using 1 micron particles or let's say 10 micron particles? Packing, are they more uniformly packed or are they have so-called heterogeneity in between them? Make sense? Are they packed relatively denser or are they packed relatively looser? Processing, which is how do you do to the powder compact. Process, heat schedule. It's always required. You are going to do heat treatment. You are doing sintering, heat treatment. You always need to apply heat. Without heat, the powder will not come together. Okay? Atmosphere. It's important for some cases. And what's the cheapest atmosphere we can use? Yes, open air. Sintering in open air. For most oxides, we can do sintering in open air. But if you are doing carbide or boride or nitride, you try to avoid air because otherwise your powder starts to oxidize. Make sense? And for non-oxide ceramics, that's what we said, carbide, boride, nitride, you have to use atmosphere, certain atmosphere. Inert, argon, helium, something like that. Okay. For oxides, certain oxides, you also have to be careful with the atmosphere because there are certain oxides that are not exactly stable. There are oxides that when you heat, it starts to decompose. For those, you have to be careful and do control atmosphere. For example, so-called ferrite or piezoelectric, that those that contain lead and other components. External pressure or constraints, sometimes people apply it during sintering. For example, so-called hot pressing. Hot pressing, which means you are heated up, at the same time you are pressed. Hot pressing, right? So these, you may apply pressure during sintering. With that, you may apply pressure to get a green pellet, to get a green body, but you may sometimes do sintering with applied pressure. And there are also other processing parameters, such as what it is? Electrical magnetic field, so-called SPS. People have electrical field or current, and sometimes microwave, of course, current. The major types of sintering. The most common one would be pressureless conventional sintering, which means you just let the green body sit in a furnace without applying any pressure, heat it up, and after you are heating, hopefully it densifies. Okay, there are so-called pressure sintering. Higher, makes sense, right? And then you have to a more complex setup, and higher density may be used if you really wanted to guarantee your higher density, and if you have to justify the cost. And of course, once you do this, your geometry become confined. You cannot do too complex shape quite often, or difficult to do. I wouldn't say you cannot, but difficult to do. Electrically assisted sintering, so-called SPS, spark plasma sintering, or flash sintering, or something similar, microwave sintering.